My mother is a yak hunter, and almost all the year she's staying with the yaks in the high mountains. My father and eldest brother passed away when I was young. And now I'm taking care of myself, my younger sister, brother, and 3-year-old niece. The best part of my day is going to school. I have my friends there, and there's so much going on. If there is no WFP food, my mother would take me out of the school because she's the only one working. If I can become an engineer, I want to bring my mother home and I want to keep her safe.
We have seen that something as small as providing meals in schools can play a huge role in whether or not children like Doji can finish schools and follow their dreams. The school meals gives parents a reason to put you to school. And now that you are in the school, you know the value of education and how much of a difference it has made in your life. So then you will never allow your children not to get an education. Bhutan is an incredibly mountainous country. We deliver food to 233 schools in every corner of Bhutan. Most of the communities are not connected by road, so we have to resort to mules, oxen, and yaks to get the food to the schools.
Yes, I think the partnership between the Royal Government and the WFP has been excellent.
WFP is proud, actually, to be partner with the Ministry of Education. Not only because we are supporting them, but they are also supporting us.
Since 1976, 1976, 1986, 1996, 2006, now 2013, still going strong. But I think the modus operandi has to keep changing. Can we have a mixed mode of feeding system with the community involvement?
The next 5 years will be the most critical because that will be the last phase of WFP's presence in Bhutan. It will be critical because we have to ensure that what we have been doing over the last 40 years doesn't suddenly lose the momentum. From WFP's side, in order to ensure the sustainability, strengthening of the government counterparts will be a very important component.
The government of Bhutan is very committed. Our children in the rural areas generally come from poorer families, and they need the head start of the school feeding program.
One good thing about Bhutan is this office is run by a national staff, you know, and the operational cost is really small. It's peanuts. To feed a child one meal is roughly 13 to 14 cents. And you know, these things taken together, it gives you a big result.